You can't give up on one specific aspect of the language, not just English, but any language. You have to
Yes.
be, because a lot of times, you know, when you speak, and if you're incorrectly saying something, the meaning of what you want to say is lost somewhere.
I think if we do not use words in the right context, that time it happens.
In the right context.
Yes, in the right context. So
happen,
I think
happen.
When we teach kids in the class, we prepare from book. Book is there in front of us and in front of the teacher. We read paragraph by paragraph and we explain to the students. So that time, I think we don't face that, teachers don't face that article problem. But when speaking on general topic, it's a little bit difficult.
There happens a lot of people. I think you really need to have, you know, I've had a very good teacher, very, very good teacher, or you have to want to work on it. Then you improve on it.
Many times I regret that I'm not a student of English medium, but I've seen that many people, they have studied in very good English schools, but the spoken is not very good.
I agree with you.
I think they are on my level or maybe a little bit better or less.
Yeah, but that happened. In fact, a lot of people feel that if your language is English, an English speaking country, maybe the US, maybe Australia, maybe New Zealand, maybe England, then your English is impeccable, absolutely flawless. But that's not true. I have spoken, I used to work in a BPO. I've spoken with Australians and Americans, and they also make mistakes.
Yes, native speakers make mistakes, I've noticed. For 5 months, I would speak with only Americans, Britishers, and lastly, I would book lesson with Australians or others as well. I just wanted to check myself that am I able to understand them, or are they able to understand me, or they ask what you say, what did you say, but nobody asked me.
That's fine.
And one more thing I've noticed, that my favorite Australian speaker is Shade Zerai. And one more is from Australia. So I noticed their vowels and the British English vowel, almost the same, but little bit pronunciation difference is there. Australians, they do not pronounce very clear, like they are swallowing some sounds, not word,
British,
but sound.
English?
British means English. British pronunciations are like little bit strong or sharp.
British English and Australian are similar because British ruled Australia also for some time.
British
American
ruled
English,
America as well.
coming to that. But American English is influenced, I don't know with what, their language. I think I feel Americans wanted, they just wanted their English to be different. Hence, they have got different terms. For example, across the entire world, petrol is petrol. Only in US is gasoline. And it makes no sense.
So many words are different.
Yes. Many words.
Cookies, biscuits, sofa, couch.
It's why. It makes no sense.
Maybe they want to
stand out.
Yeah, stand out in the crowd. We are something different. Personally, I don't like American pronunciations very much. I prefer British English. I found it interesting and very soothing to listen as well.
And a lot of people, the popular belief is that British English is the correct English to use. I prefer British English. This is what was taught to us in school. And I, not just because it was taught to us in school, because I think British English is the correct English. A lot of words which are in British English, the pronunciation that is, they seem to make more sense. And as I just said, American English, just because they want to sound different, they are different.
Yes. Few pronunciations I don't like can't, can't, not.
That is accent. Nah.
No, but that pronunciation is... not. Our pronunciation, our vowel is not there. They say nah, not. That kind of
thing. I think that is to do with the accent.
No, their vowel pronunciations are totally different. Because one of my friends, she is obsessed with American accent. And we both enrolled for accent reduction course. So she was very upset.
We both enrolled.
We both enrolled. She's from Delhi and I'm from here. Means we got introduced or we come to know each other in that class only.
So we met each other.
We come to know. So she was very upset. And after that, we are in touch. So June, I think 13, 14 months. So she joined American accent course. So she always record video. She has her own YouTube channel as well. So she would send me, this sound is like that, this sound is like that, this pronunciation is like that. That's why I come to know what is the exact difference between British pronunciations and Americans. So their vowels are different. So in this way, I've studied a little bit about American vowels and consonant.
But do you know, it is said that American, the American accent is the easiest accent to understand.
Yeah, I also heard that American accent is easy, but I found British accent easy. Maybe due to my choice.
I think the reason American accent is the easiest to understand is because of movies. We see more American movies than British movies or any other movies. I think that's the reason why. That's what I think.
I don't watch movies. That's why I'm not interested in American accent.
Yeah, that's the reason. But I think that's the reason why, because of movies, American accent is easier to understand.
Okay. Are you tired or hungry?
I am both. How would an American pronounce tomato?
Tomato. British pronunciation I know, but tomato. Tomato. Tomato.
Tomato.
Yeah.
I think it's tomato, right? Potato.
Yeah, I'm a little bit confused, but either one is correct.
let me search tomato pronunciation. Because I use tomato.
Okay.
On Google, tomato. I started this new thing.
What's name?
Tomato. If you search the meaning of a word, search the pronunciation of a word, you get three options. Indian pronunciation, American pronunciation, and British pronunciation.
Yeah, it's from beginning, and I have switched my mobile to UK pronunciation.
So, listen to this.
Tomato.
Tomato.
And this is British pronunciation.
Tomato.
Tomato.
And this is American pronunciation.
Tomato.
Tomato. Quite different.
I will go with Indian pronunciation.
Tomato.
When we speak in our region, we have to speak like people would understand us easily. Otherwise, they will make fun of us.
Yeah, completely agree. So obviously, we can't go to the vegetable market and say tomato. We have to say the Hindi word for tomato.
Yes.
So, I remember... I know whether I saw it in a movie or it happened with some, I don't know that movie, that a person had gone to the vegetable market and they wanted a lady finger. But the word for lady finger is also okra. They said they want okra and the person was confused what they want. He thought the person wants coconut because the Hindi word for coconut and okra is similar. So that person gave them that. But they said, no, I want okra. So that took some time. a lot of times, you know, you read recipes of things, and then English, and they use these words which seem like this, you know, but
then like brinjal and eggplant and kind of
things. Yeah. But then, okay, this is what we want really now. So simple. That's what we come to do. That's what we do when we find out the Hindi word.
Yeah. So many things. Indians have created their own English. Britishers and Americans, they cannot understand what is the exact meaning of those words. Many words are there.
That's good. I'm happy. Very nice. Because, you know, I think in our country, we speak English a lot.
Yes.
A lot, and not just speaking, if you think about it, we also give a lot of importance to English. Like if you make a mistake in Hindi or any other language, India, an Indian language, it's fine, not a huge thing. But if you make a mistake in English, it is a huge thing. Like no one is supposed to make a mistake in English, it is a crime.